Hello, we are Jamie, Maria and Hazel from the Optima CDT at the Universities of Strathclyde and Edinburgh, and today we are going to shine a light on the phenomenon of fluorescence, where we'll look at what actually causes things to fluoresce and how this can have important real-life applications. Many molecules around you have the ability to fluoresce without you even realising it. The term fluorescence was first coined back in 1852 by George G. Stokes, who observed the fluorescence of a molecule called quinine, which you can still find in tonic water today. Since then, fluorescence has been observed in many different materials, such as oil and diamonds, and has also been observed in nature in the likes of fish, coral, and even fluorescent frog was discovered only this year. So what actually causes these things to fluoresce? Well, fluorescence can be induced when a molecule is excited by shining light upon it. This then causes the molecule to release light back in the form of a different colour of light. Following the release of light, the molecule then becomes non-fluorescent again. Now, different molecules will emit different colours of light depending on their chemical properties. This phenomenon has many applications. It has everyday uses such as a security measure in passport control, checking for counterfeit money. Fluorescence also has important medical applications where it is now being used in surgery to identify healthy and diseased tissue. Fluorescence is still being used extensively in biomedical research where it can be used to observe and analyse biological molecules in a non-destructive way by either looking at the molecule's own fluorescence or attaching a fluorescent molecule to it. Here at Optima, we think fluorescence is great and we hope you do too. Thanks for listening.